Here we go again, folks. Here we go again. Here we go again. My goodness. Here live with Mike at Mike's. Oh, can't get that thing to focus. Ooh-wee. Mike's magic. Auto detailing and paint enhancement. Why is this not focusing, Jason? You know more about this stuff than I do. Why won't it focus? Because my hand's in the way? Yeah, maybe that's it. Anyway, hey, buddy. As you all remember, we're through with this 06 Nissan 240 SX, ceramic coated, all that. Daddy, 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 da. Waiting on the owner to come pick it up. But on a bright Saturday afternoon here in Sharpsburg, Georgia, I got a new project in here. One of my regulars just brought to me. He is a kind of a what I call a neighborhood used car dealer. He spends a lot of money on these cars, get them mechanically perfect, and the mechanic a lot of time uses up my detailing budget. So this is a budget job, so it'll be relatively simple. Man, it's a I forget 81 Monte Carlo, something like that. As in, the paint has been severely neglected, Jason. Severely neglected, severely neglected. Of course, as you might imagine, Jason, the headlights need restoring. We're gonna do that. This is a budget job. He gave me a budget, and I've got to fit what I do into the budget. So this will be a relatively simple and short project. I always say that, but it never turns out that way. But I mean, if you look at this hood, it is really screwed up, Jason, and anybody else that might happen to be watching. Since there's two people watching, y'all give me a comment or something. Let me know who's out there. Who's out there? But like stuff like that, Jason, that's not gonna go away. That's, I don't know if y'all can see that. That's not gonna go away. There's a lot of things in this paint that at this level of detailing are not going to go away. Oh, man. Ah, it's a sad day, sad day. This will improve a little bit. You can see here, some up on the roof, Jason. Hey, baby. Hey, Miss Angela. Like that spot over there, that's all the way down to the primer. And my suspect is, once again, commercial car washes. And some of this looks like it might be, some of these scratches look like it might be cats or something. I'm not real sure. But at the level of detailing I'm going to do here, these scratches are not going to go away. Not at this level. I'll explain to you what I'm going to be doing here in just a minute. But I'm just giving you an idea of how terrible, terrible, terrible this is. I don't know if y'all can see all that crap on this paint, all the scratches that are in it. Oh, man. The trim is all, as most of you might imagine, pretty bad shape. I'll clean it up as best I can, but it's not in the budget to restore it. Ugh. The glass has got a lot of contaminants on it and that sort of thing. You could see the oxidation there, I think. What I'm going to be doing will take care of a lot of that, but not all of it. He wanted these wheels polished up, but that's not in the budget. I'm going to clean them up as best I can, but I will not be polishing on these wheels in all likelihood, unless I just get bored. And there again, you can see the damage there. Oh boy. Of course, this back bumper, I mean, there's like no paint left much at all. And you can see where that's clear coat right there. That's about the only clear coat left on this bumper. I might can improve that a little bit, but not a lot. This thing is really, really nasty. I just gonna try to get it as presentable as I can. And so, what I'm gonna be doing to this car, or what I anticipate I'm gonna be doing, is we'll do the pre-rinse with the power washer. hey, Mr. Robert, pre-rinse with a power washer. Then I'm gonna foam it with a diluted down solution of Purple Power Boat and Vehicle Wash. Let it dwell. I'm gonna have to pull it up under that tree out there to get it in the shade. You don't wanna do that in direct sunlight, particularly on black paint. It'll dry about as fast as you put it on there, which is not good, not good. Anyway, I'll foam it with that. Give it a thorough rinsing. And then we're gonna do the contact wash with a low pile, a scrubbing microfiber mitt, as I call it, and Meguiar's Wash Plus, which is, to me, my opinion is the only time you should use that stuff, it's really, really good stuff, is when you're gonna be doing some form of paint correction after that. Then I'll decontaminate it with the Iron X or a similar product to get rid of some of the remaining metal contaminants that are all over this car. Then we'll clay bar it with an aggressive grade of clay bar. Try to remove the rest of those contaminants from the paint and the glass. You can clay bar glass, folks. It actually helps glass a lot when you do that. Tempered glass. You don't want to be clay barring like the rear view mirrors, though it'll scratch them. Oh moly. Oh, scared me for a minute. I saw my own reflection in the glass. Scared me. I was like, uh-oh, no, am I filming myself again? No, don't want to be doing that. And after the clay bar, of course, the whole vehicle will be paint prepped. And then I'm going to do a one-step polish and see how good that turns out. But that's all he's got in the budget. I'll restore the headlights, which is really not in the budget, but a lot of times I throw the headlights in for free anyway. And I'll probably rinse down the engine bay just a little bit. And then we'll put some form of sealant on here. He wants me to experiment with the quick detailer that's made just for black paint to see how that looks. So we'll do that before I put the higher grade sealant on there. That quick detailer, most of that stuff is pretty effective, folks, but the longevity of it's only like a couple of weeks, a month at the best under ideal conditions. Quick detailer is not made for longevity. All it's designed to do is exactly what it says, quick detail. That's to get dust off. When you got a car that just got dusty, it's not dirty, you just want to get the dust off of it. And I'm not talking about pine pollen either. You'll scratch it if you do pine pollen that way. But anyway, he had wanted the interior done and the wheels polished and all this and that and the other, and some tint removed from the windows. Not enough money in the budget for all that. So we're gonna make it look as good as I can. I say we, me. And fit within the budget, and we'll see how this bad boy turns out. You guys, if you're watching on YouTube, hey, consider hitting that subscribe button and keep up to date with what's happening on this project. And you can also go back and look at playlists for previous projects, some of which were pretty cool cars, like I think it was a 47 Cadillac I did not too long ago, which was a cool car. And I'm in the process of uploading this series on this car for those of you who didn't see the series. But anyway, I'm gonna get to work. Bye, folks.